Hello students, welcome to All In Scholar classes. So today I will be taking the fifth part of the chapter Coal and Petroleum. It is fifth chapter from class 8 science. In my four previous parts, I have already discussed about coal and petroleum. Okay, so today we will be taking another natural fossil fuel, that is a natural gas. Today's discussion will be on natural gas. Okay. So we shall be seeing the composition of it, okay, what is the composition of the gases of which it is made up of. Then we will see its occurrence, where does it occur. After that we will see the uses of natural gases, where it is used and how useful it is to man. Then the advantages of CNG, we will see what is CNG. CNG is a part of natural gas and we will see its advantages. Can it be prepared in lab? I will be explaining some of the questions that can these natural gas be prepared in the lab, or any of the fossil fuel, can they be prepared in the lab? CNG acts as a cleaner fuel. Why is it so? That explanation also will be given to you. Then the natural resources are limited. How they are limited and how there will be a crisis in coming years, that we are going to be seeing. Then the consequences of burning fossil fuels. We are using fossil fuels, coal, petroleum, these natural gases, so we burn them. So what is the after effect of it? What is the consequence of it? Is it giving a good effect or it's giving a bad effect? Then saving petrol and diesel, we will see how we can save petrol and diesel. Why fossil fuel can last 100 years only? Why this fossil fuel is degrading, it is being lost, and it will be lasting only for 100 more years, not more than that. Okay, so this question also will be answered. So we shall be discussing all these points today and about natural gas. Okay, so I have already discussed about coal and petroleum in my previous videos. If you want to learn about coal and petroleum, the details you can go and see in the last four videos. Okay, and today I will be finishing this chapter. So let's start with this natural gas. So what is a natural gas? Natural gas is also a fossil fuel. Okay, we have already discussed some of the fossil fuels like coal and petroleum in our previous videos. Today we are going to discuss another fossil fuel, that is a natural gas. Okay, so it's a fossil fuel. Okay, now we shall talk about its color and its smell. So natural gas is colorless and it's odorless. Means there is no color, there is no smell in it. Okay, so natural gas is colorless and odorless. Okay, this is a very important fossil fuel. Can you guess why? Because it is very easy to transport through pipes from one place to another. Okay, so this natural gas is the very important fossil fuel, because this is the only natural gas, we can say that, which is very easy to transport from one place to another through a pipe. Okay, so it's easy to transport from one place to another through a pipe. Okay, so these are some of the key features about a natural gas, that it is also a fossil fuel. Natural gas is colorless. It's odorless. okay, and it is very easy to transport from one place to another through a pipe. Okay, now the question is, okay, what is the composition of a natural gas? Okay, so we will be seeing the composition. If we see about its composition, this natural gas, it's mainly contained of methane is there, ethane, propane and butane. Okay, so it's composed of natural gas composition. Okay, so it is mainly composed of methane. Okay, ethane is there, propane and butane. Okay, so it is made up of mainly these four gases. So 85% of it is composed of methane. Means the major constituent is of methane. If a question is asked in one word question, what is the major constituent? Which gas is the major constituent of a natural gas? So methane. How much percent? 85%. Ethane is 10%. Okay, so you can see that rest all are having very less percent, but maximum is for methane. Propane is 3%. Okay, rest all are having very less compositions. So methane is having the highest composition of a natural gas, that is 85%. Ethane 10, propane 3 and butane. Now one thing I would like to tell you, when this natural gas is compressed at high pressure, then it is called CNG, compressed natural gas. Okay, so sometimes it is asked that what is compressed natural gas. Compressed natural gas, it stands, CNG stands for compressed natural gas. Okay, so when a natural gas is compressed, okay, it is compressed at high pressure, keeping the pressure very high. This is called as compressed natural gas. Okay, so when a natural gas is compressed at a high pressure, it is called as compressed natural gas, that is CNG. Okay, next let's see the occurrence of a natural gas. So where do these natural gas, they are occur? So this natural gas was formed millions of years ago along with petroleum. Okay, so this natural gas was formed millions of years ago along with petroleum. Jab petroleum ka formation hua tha, jab petroleum occur kiya tha millions of years ago, usi time hume kya mili thi, natural gas bhi mili. Okay, when these microscopic sea plants and animals died and got buried under sand and mud, or you can say clay. Okay, so kya hua tha ki bahut sare sea living organisms the, like microscopic sea living organisms, they plants and animals, they died. Okay, they died and got buried in the sea under the water and sand mud and clay, and that has been transformed after hundreds of years as a fossil fuel in the form of a natural gas. Okay, so these plants and animals under the anaerobic condition, they have changed to gas. Kis condition mein gas mein convert hue? Natural gas mein. Anaerobic condition means in the absence of air. Jab unko air nahi mili, jab unko oxygen nahi mila, in the condition of absence of air, that is the anaerobic condition. Anaerobic condition mein ये किसमें कन्वर्ट हो गया? नेचुरल गैस में कन्वर्ट हो गया. ओके, सो दीज नेचुरल गैसेस इज जनरली ट्रैप्ड बिटवीन इम्प्रिजन्ड रॉक्स, समटाइम्स अलोंग विद पेट्रोलियम, ओके, एंड समटाइम्स विदाउट पेट्रोलियम. ओके, सो ऑक्सीडेंस की अगर बात करें तो नेचुरल गैस वॉज फॉर्म मिलियंस ऑफ ईयर्स अगो. कब ये बने थे? मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स अगो. फॉर्म मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स अगो अलोंग विद पेट्रोलियम. पेट्रोलियम के साथ ये मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स अगो में ही बन गए थे. ओके, अब नेक्स्ट इज कि इनका अपीयरेंस हुआ कैसे. तो जो माइक्रोस्कोपिक सी एनिमल्स थे या प्लांट्स थे, ओके, माइक्रोस्कोपिक सी एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स थे, ओके, दे डाइड. ये क्या हो गया? डाइड कर गए, ये मर गए. और आफ्टर गेटिंग डाइड दे गॉट बरीड. इसके अंदर दफन हो गए, बरीड अंडर सैंड एंड मड. ओके, सैंड और मड में ये बरीड हो गए. और जब इनको एनारोबिक कंडीशन मिली, कौन सी कंडीशन मिली? एनारोबिक कंडीशन. एनारोबिक कंडीशन क्या है? इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एयर. सो दे गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू fossil fuel natural gas. They got converted into, you can say they got converted into gas. Anaerobic condition hui. और इसमें ये क्या बन गया? Gas बन गया. Okay? So these were formed millions of years ago along with petroleum, microscopic sea animals and plant. They died, got buried under the sand and mud, and in the anaerobic condition means when there was an absence of air, they got converted into the gas. There this natural gas has been occurred. Okay, so these natural gas, they remain, they are found trapped between imprisoned rocks. Sometimes they are found along with petroleum and sometimes without petroleum. Kya hota hai ki kabhi ye petroleum ke saath hote hain, पेट्रोलियम के साथ होंगे तो क्या होगा? एक इम्प्रिजन रॉक होगी, उसमें पहले पेट्रोलियम होगा और उसके ऊपर नेचुरल गैस होती है. और कभी कभी ये विदाउट पेट्रोलियम के भी पाए जाते हैं. ओके, नाउ वी विल सी द अकरेंस ऑफ दीज नेचुरल गैसेस इन इंडिया, इन आवर कंट्री इन इंडिया, वेयर दीज नेचुरल गैसेस अकर मोस्टली. Okay, so in our country, occurrence of natural gas in India, in our country, they are found mainly in Tripura. Okay, Tripura is there. They are also found in Rajasthan, Maharashtra. Okay, these are the states where they are being found. Okay, and also in the Krishna Godavari Krishna Godavari Delta. Okay? So in the Krishna Godavari
बहुत ही हाई होती है। इफ यू गो इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट इज इन पार्ट 3
from there you can refer what is calorific value. Okay. So automobiles does not cause pollution because of its high calorific value. Okay. So basically, ये दो major news हो गए. एक तो ये कि ये as a chemical or chemicals or fertilizers में use होते हैं, और दूसरा ये कि ये automobiles में use होते हैं for new vehicles because of its causing less pollution. And इनका less pollution इसलिए होता है क्योंकि इनके पास एक high calorific value होती है. Okay. So this was about the uses of natural gases. So let's see the advantages of CNG. So these CNG, they are directly used for burning in homes and factories where it can be supplied through pipes. Okay, as I have already told you, they can be transferred from one place to another using a pipes. Okay, so such a network of pipes in India, it exists in Vadodara, in a state Gujarat, and some part of Delhi and other places also. Okay, so you must have heard, आपने सुना होगा pipeline, gas pipeline, आजकल बहुत famous है, gas pipeline चल रही है. तो what is that? Basically, it is that CNG only which is being transported from one place to another using a pipe. Okay, so initially it was used in Vadodara, Gujarat, and then in Delhi. Nowadays in some other cities also within the country it has been used. Okay, so the first advantage is directly sent slow pipe from one place to another. Okay, from one place to another in homes and even in some of the factories. Okay, okay, directly sent through pipes from one place to another, homes and factories. So if we talk in India, initially it was in Gujarat. Okay, in Gujarat it was in Vadodara. Okay, and then in Delhi, and nowadays in some other places also this pipeline has been done. Okay, the secondary advantage of CNG is that it acts as a very good fuel in automobiles. Okay, why it is a very good fuel in automobiles? Because it produces less pollution. Okay, pollution बहुत कम होता है इससे, इसलिए ये automobiles में आजकल बहुत ज़्यादा use हो रही है. CNG autos are there and CNG cars are being also there. Okay, so used in automobiles. Okay, in various vehicles. In transport vehicles. Okay, the reason why instead of petrol, this is nowadays CNG gas is used because it gives less pollution. Okay, next is for that it acts as a cleaner fuel. Why it acts as a cleaner fuel? Because if we compare it with petroleum, that is with petrol and diesel, it produces less pollution. Okay, so acts as a cleaner fuel. Okay, because it gives pollution less as compared to petrol and diesel. And the CNG is also used for power generation. If you want to generate power, this CNG is used. Okay, so CNG is also used as power generation. is there. So used in automobiles and transport of vehicles, acts as a cleaner fuel since it is giving less pollution as compared to petrol and diesel. CNG is also used as a power generation. Okay, in power generation, CNG is used. So this was the advantages of CNG. Now the question is that we know that this petroleum is a fossil fuel, this natural gas is a fossil fuel. Okay? Natural gas and petroleum both are a fossil fuel. Okay? Now the question is that today's are the fossil fuels. As I have already told you, they are being made by the dead plants and animals, microscopic sea plants and animals, when they get buried under the sand and clay. So these fossil fuels in the form of petroleum and natural gases, after millions of years, they occur. So now the question is that, is this natural gas and petroleum can be prepared in laboratory? Okay, in the labs we do lots of experiment. So can these be prepared in a laboratory from dead organisms? Agar ye dead organisms se hi bante hain, to kya hum unko laboratory mein prepare kar sakte hain dead organisms ke through? Dead plants and dead animals, microscopic sea plants and animals ke through, can these be prepared? What do you think? So the answer is a big no. No. You can't prepare it in a laboratory. So what are the reasons why these can't be prepared in a laboratory? So the first reason is that their process is a very slow process. Okay? बहुत ये जो fossil fuel बनते हैं इनका जो process होता है वो बहुत ही slow process होता है. तो उतने slow process को laboratory करना will be a tough task. Okay? And the second thing is that कि their formation cannot be created in the laboratory. जो condition उनको चाहिए, okay? वो condition हम laboratory में नहीं दे सकते हैं. As we have already discussed, क्या conditions चाहिए थी? कि पहले तो वो microscopic sea animals होंगे और plants होंगे. वो dead हो जाएंगे तो they are buried under sand and clay. Then under anaerobic condition, that is in the absence of air, at high temperature and high pressure, they get converted into fossil fuel. So do you think is this formation or this condition can be given in the laboratory? How can we make this type of condition, such an anaerobic condition also? We need to bury them under sand, clay, muds. Okay? And after thousands of years, millions of years, not only thousands of years, millions of years, they are going to be converted into fossil fuel. So this condition we can't give in the laboratories. Okay? So if a question is being asked in an exam, can we coal, petroleum and the natural gas, all three are fossil fuel, can they be prepared in laboratory? The answer is no. The reasons are, the first reason is that formation ka jo process hai wo bahut very slow process hai. Okay? So their formation is very slow. Their formation is very slow. तो एक तो ये रीजन है कि वी कांट प्रिपेयर देम इन लेबोरेटरी, वी कांट प्रिपेयर फॉसिल फ्यूल लाइक कोल, पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल in labs. Okay, so we can't prepare them in labs. The first thing is that their formation is very slow, and the second thing is that we can't create such conditions required. Okay, जो condition उनको चाहिए कि वो fossil fuel में convert हो, उन conditions को हम नहीं दे सकते, इसलिए इसका answer no है. The answer is no. We can't prepare fossil fuel like coal, petroleum and natural gas in lab because their formation is very slow and we can't create such condition which is required for their conversion in the fossil fuel. Okay. Now the next question is, as I have already told you, that CNG is considered as a cleaner fuel. So why is CNG considered as a cleaner fuel?
Okay, आजकल सोलर एनर्जी बहुत यूज होती है.
solar energy. Okay? So now we will see that some natural resources are limited. How they are limited? Some natural resources are limited. So we know that the natural resources are of two types. Okay? The one is the exhaustible and the other is the inexhaustible. Okay? So, exhaustible natural resource and an inexhaustible natural resource. Okay? So, here we will talk about exhaustible natural resource. Exhaustible natural resources are those natural resources which are present in a limited amount. Kya hai? Exhaustible natural resource kya hai? Limited amount mein present hai. And after a use, overuse of it, it gets finished. Jaise jaise iska use hota jayega exhaustible resource ka, ek time aayega jab ye finish ho jayega. Means it is available in a limited amount. Okay? So exhaustible resource is present in limited amount and it is going to be finished, it is going to be run down, or it is going to be exhausted at time. Okay? So in natural resource mein jo exhaustible resource hai wo ek limited amount mein hai. और ये एग्जॉस्टेबल रिसोर्सेस कौन से हैं? The fossil fuels, the minerals, our forests, wildlife, ये सारे एग्जॉस्टेबल रिसोर्स हैं. क्यों? क्योंकि ये लिमिटेड अमाउंट में प्रेजेंट हैं. ओके? सो दिस एग्जॉस्टेबल रिसोर्सेस. Okay, exhaustible resources are which resources? They are the fossil fuels like coal is there, petroleum is there, and natural gas. Okay, next is the minerals are there, wildlife are there, forests are there. Okay, like this so many exhaustible resources are there. All these are present in a limited amount. Okay, so we know that this coal, petroleum and natural gas are the fossil fuel. It is being required that these dead animals, dead organism you can say, after millions of years they get converted into fuel. Okay? So these fossil fuels mein kya hai? Coal hai, petroleum hai, natural gas hai. So jo dead organism the, they took millions of years to get converted into fuels. Okay? Fossil fuels in fact you can say. कितना टाइम लगा उनको? मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स. ओके, दे टुक मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स टू गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू फॉसिल फ्यूल्स. बट करेंटली क्या है, देयर डिमांड इज वेरी हाई. इनकी जो डिमांड है वो हाई रेट पे है. ओके, सो अगर डिमांड होगी तो कंजम्पशन ज्यादा होगा. जिस भी चीज की डिमांड ज्यादा होगी उसका कंजम्पशन ज्यादा हो रहा है. ठीक है, आजकल सबके पास ऑटोमोबाइल्स हैं, सबके पास व्हीकल्स हैं, कार, स्कूटर, टू व्हीलर्स, फोर व्हीलर्स, एवरीबडी इज हैविंग. तो जितने ज्यादा व्हीकल्स रन होंगे उतना ज्यादा पेट्रोल का कंजम्पशन होगा. क्यों? क्योंकि पेट्रोल की डिमांड बढ़ चुकी है. एंशिएंट टाइम में क्या होता था, पीपल यूज टू वॉक बाय फूट, मिलियंस दे टुक सो मेनी ईयर्स टू सेल, दे यूज बोट्स, दे गो बाय साइकिल्स, दे गो बाय फूट, पैदल चले जाते थे लोग बहुत दूर तक फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर कंट्री में. बट नो, टुडे वी डोंट गो लाइक दिस. सो द कंजम्पशन ऑफ दीज फॉसिल फ्यूल इज एट हाई रेट एंड shorten, they are going to be limited. They are going to live only 100 more years. Okay, so these are available in the limited quantities. Okay, so some natural resources are limited ka matlab yahi hua ki jo fossil fuels hai inka consumption bahut zyada ho raha hai. Okay, unki demand bahut high hai, unka consumption bahut zyada ho raha hai, to ab ye bahut hi limited quantity mein reh jayenge hain aur it is calculated that they are going to live only 100 more years. Okay, so this was about natural resources are limited. Maybe in two words question, two marks question, it can ask that some natural resources are limited. How? So you are first going to explain what is exhaustible resource. These fossil fuels, they come in exhaustible resources, means they are limited. Limited in amount. जैसे जैसे उनका यूज होगा, वन डे दे आर गोइंग टू फिनिश आउट, दे आर गोइंग टू रन आउट, दे आर गोइंग टू बी एग्जॉस्टेड. ओके, now the next we will see the consequences of burning fossil fuel. Okay, we are using fossil fuel. Fossil fuel is in high demand, but what is the result of burning it? What is the consequence of burning these fossil fuels? Okay, so you can say the result of burning fossil fuels. Okay, what is going to happen when we burn these fossil fuels? There is two main drawbacks of burning a fossil fuel. Firstly, there is going to be an increase in pollution. जब fossil fuel को बंद करेंगे तो सबसे बड़ा drawback क्या है? Pollution बढ़ जाएगा. And second thing is that it is going to affect our global warming. Global warming में भी ये affect करेगा. Okay, so increase in pollution की air pollution की अगर बात करें, सबसे पहले let's discuss about increase in air pollution. How the burning of this fossil fuel increases the air pollution. Okay, so the burning of fossil fuel results in the release of unburned carbon particles in the air. As we all know that fossil fuels like coal, coal is made up of 98% of its is of carbon. Petrol is also releasing carbon. Okay, so these fossil fuels, when they are being burned, the unburned carbon particles is released. Okay, एयर में क्या रिलीज होगा? कार्बन रिलीज होगी. सो द पार्टिकल्स एक्ट एज पोल्यूटेंट्स. और ये जो कार्बन पार्टिकल्स आएंगे एयर में, ये कैसे एक्ट करते हैं? दे एक्ट एज अ पोल्यूटेंट्स. और वो क्या क्रिएट करके? एयर पोल्यूशन. दे इंक्रीजेस द एयर पोल्यूशन. ऑलरेडी एटमोसफियर में एयर पोल्यूशन बहुत ज्यादा है, और जब ये फॉसिल फ्यूल बर्न होते हैं तो इनसे भी कार्बन पार्टिकल्स का रिलीज होगा, तो पॉल्यूशन और इंक्रीज होगा और बढ़ेगा. ओके, सो द फॉसिल फ्यूल रिलीज सम पॉइजनस गैसेस आल्सो, सच एज कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड इज देयर, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड इन द एटमॉस्फेयर. ओके, दे आल्सो रिलीज सम पॉइजनस गैसेस लाइक कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड एंड सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. ओके, सो इंक्रीज इन एयर पॉल्यूशन. सबसे पहली चीज इंक्रीज इन एयर पॉल्यूशन तो क्या है कि जब फॉसिल फ्यूल बर्न, जब ये बर्न होंगे तो व्हाट डू दे रिलीज? दे रिलीज कार्बन पार्टिकल्स. ओके, अब ये जो कार्बन पार्टिकल्स हैं, दीज कार्बन पार्टिकल्स दे एक्ट एज What they act as? They act as pollutants. ये कैसे act करते हैं? ये pollutant की तरह act करेंगे. और जब ये pollutants की तरह act करेंगे, so they are going to increase air pollution. Increase air pollution. Okay? ये तो पहली बात हो गई कि ये air pollution कैसे increase कर रहे हैं. दूसरा drawback और क्या है कि जब ये fossil fuel जो है burn किए जाते हैं तो ये और क्या release करते हैं? एक तो ये release करते हैं carbon particles को और दूसरा ये बहुत सारी release करते हैं poisonous gas. Secondly ये क्या release करेंगे? बहुत सारी poisonous gases को release करते हैं. ओके अब ये poisonous gases कौन सी होंगी? कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड है. ओके और दूसरी poisonous gas है सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. सो लाइक दिस दे आर इंक्रीजिंग द एयर पोल्यूशन बाय इंक्रीजिंग कार्बन पार्टिकल्स इन द एटमॉस्फेयर. दीस कार्बन पार्टिकल्स दे एक्ट एज अ पोल्यूटेंट्स एंड दे इंक्रीज द एयर पोल्यूशन. सेकेंडली दे रिलीज सम पॉइजनस गैसेस इन द एटमॉस्फेयर लाइक कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड इज बीइंग रिलीज, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड इज रिलीज इन एटमॉस्फेयर. सो दे एक्ट्स और दे इंक्रीजेस आवर एयर पोल्यूशन. ओके सो ये तो इंक्रीज इन एयर पोल्यूशन की बात हो गई. नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं ग्लोबल वार्मिंग पे कैसे इनका इफेक्ट हो रहा है. Second is global warming. Okay, now let's see global warming में क्या होगा. These fossil fuels when they are burned, they release large amount of carbon dioxide in the air. Okay, so as the amount of carbon dioxide increases, it results in the increase in global temperature of the earth and leads to global warming. Okay? जब ये fossil fuel burn होते हैं तो ये क्या release करते हैं? Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide अगर atmosphere में आपका बढ़ रहा है, increase हो रहा है, तो it means कि जो global temperature है हमारे earth का, that temperature is going to increase. और if that temperature is increasing, it is going to leads to global warming. Okay? So global warming में क्या हो रहा है कि when these fossil fuels are burned, what they release? They release carbon dioxide in the air. Okay? They release carbon dioxide in the air. अब कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड रिलीज होगा इट इज गोइंग टू रिजल्ट इन इंक्रीज इन अर्थ का ग्लोबल टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा. ओके अर्थ का जब ग्लोबल टेम्परेचर बढ़ेगा तो दैट इज अल्टीमेटली गोइंग टू लीड टू ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. इससे क्या होगा? ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. ओके सो वी हैव सीन दैट बर्निंग ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल लीड्स टू एयर पोल्यूशन एंड इट्स लीड्स टू ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. ओके of petrol and diesel. How is petroleum? That is petrol and diesel can be saved. Okay. So in India, we talk in India, a petrol conservation research association has been made. PCRA. Okay. एक PCRA advisory है. इसका क्या full form है? The full form is Petroleum Conservation Research Association, okay? PCRA. Okay? So Petroleum Conservation Research Association advises people to save petrol and diesel while driving. They have given 4 tips for it. Okay, so we shall be discussing about those 4 tips. What are they? Let's discuss. So let's see the PCR tips. They have given 4 tips. The first is that we should drive at constant and moderate speed. ओके स्पीड कैसी रखनी है एक कांस्टेंट स्पीड रखनी है एक मॉडरेट स्पीड रखनी है एज फार एज पॉसिबल ओके इससे क्या होगा कांस्टेंट और मॉडरेट स्पीड रखने से क्या फायदा है अगर बहुत हाई स्पीड आप रखते हैं ड्राइविंग की या बहुत स्लो स्पीड रखते हैं आप ड्राइविंग की तो जो फ्यूल का कंजम्पशन है वो ज्यादा होगा ओके इट इज गोइंग टू वेस्ट फ्यूल ओके सो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट इज योर टिप्स is given is drive at constant okay it's not like sometimes you are driving on 20 and sometimes you are driving on 120 not like that you should have a constant and moderate speed okay this is going to save fuel because very high speed and very low speed in both the cases there is a lot of waste of fuel Okay, so next is that we should switch off the engine if we are at red light or where we have to wait. The places where we have to wait for a longer, जहाँ पे आपको ज़्यादा देर के लिए wait करना है, या जो है कि red light पे आप खड़े हो, तो you should switch off the engine. Okay, so this is also going to save fuel. Switch off engine. Red light and places where we have to wait. Sometimes it's like there is a very big jam and you know that jam is not going to be cleared before 15 minutes. So you need not to waste the fuel for that 15 minutes. Just switch off the engine. Okay? Because this is not only us, we need to think of our coming generations that if we are going to consume and conserve and we are going to save this petrol and diesel, it is going to help our future generation. Okay? So, next is that we should ensure a correct tire pressure. Tire ka jo pressure hai, wheel mein jo tire se unke jo pressure hai, wo hamesha correct hona chahiye because too high and too low pressure based fuel. अगर बहुत high pressure है tyre में या बहुत low pressure है तो दोनों से fuel का wastage होता है. Okay? So ensure a correct tyre pressure. Okay? That's why we should always check the pressure. कि बहुत low भी ना हो और बहुत ज़्यादा भी ना हो. एक हर vehicle में एक प्रेशर अपने टायर में रखना ओके एंड द फोर्थ एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट यू शुड ऑलवेज गिव योर व्हीकल टू अ रेगुलर मेंटेनेंस अगर आप रेगुलर मेंटेनेंस कराते रहेंगे व्हीकल का तो भी जो है कि कंजम्पशन जो है पेट्रोल और डीजल का वो भी कम होगा दूसरा आप पोल्यूशन को भी कम करेंगे बहुत ज्यादा एयर पोल्यूशन से ensure for a regular maintenance of a vacuum. Okay, you should always maintain your vacuum. You should always send your vacuum to garage for its regular maintenance. Okay, so these are the four tips that is given by PCRA, that is the Petroleum Conservation Reserve Association, Research Association. It gives four tips: drive at constant speed and moderate speed, drive off engine, switch off engine at red light and places where you have to wait for long, ensure a correct tire pressure, ensure for a regular maintenance of vehicles. Okay, so like this you can save petrol and diesels. Okay, so now the question is that, as we have got to know that these fossil fuels, they are going only to last for 100 years. A fossil fuel bus 100 years all rahenge. Okay, so why is it that? What is going to happen after 100 years and why these fossil fuels, they are going to last only for 100 years? Okay, let's see this thing. Okay, so next question is, why fossil fuels is going to last for 100 years only? Okay, so we need to answer it. The first thing is that fossil fuel are exhaustible resource, means it is a limited resource, which means that they are not present in abundance in the earth. Abundance mein nahi present hai earth mein, aisa ek limited amount, ek limited quantity mein ye earth mein present hai. They take hundreds and thousands of years to replenish. Dobara banne ke liye inko 100 to thousands of years lagte hain. And rate at which they are being consumed today, itna zyada inka demand hai, itna high rate hai inki consumption ka, ki inka rapid replace ho raha hai, turant hi replace ho deta hai. Okay, it means that more amount of fossil fuel are being used, to jitna zyada use ho raha hai utna zyada banna bhi chahiye. बट बनने में क्या है, 100 टू थाउजेंड ऑफ इयर्स लगते हैं. ओके, सो हेंस द साइंटिस्ट क्लेम दैट दे आर गोइंग टू रिप्लेनिश कंप्लीटली इन 100 इयर्स. ये 100 इयर्स में पूरा फिनिश हो जाएगा, यूज हो जाएगा. ओके, आई होप दिस मच बी क्लियर टू यू व्हाई इट इज गोइंग टू बी फिनिश्ड विद इन 100 इयर्स. बिकॉज दीज फॉसिल फ्यूल्स आर एग्जॉस्टेबल रिसोर्स, means they are not present in abundance in the earth, they are present in a limited amount. Okay, aur jo inka requirement hai, jo inki demand hai, wo bahut high hai and it is increasing day by day, aur inki demand day by day aur badhti hi ja rahi hai, to inka consumption bahut high hai, jabki they take 100 to 1000 years to be replenished. Okay, so the scientists, they have claimed that these fossil fuels, they are going to last only for next 100 years and after that they are going to be totally finished. Okay, so this was all about, we have discussed today about natural gases and some points about fossil fuels. So here the chapter that is coal and petroleum, part 5 is also being finished, and here we have finished the whole chapter. Okay, so the chapter has been finished. Hope you have learned a lot about coal, petroleum and natural gas. These three fossil fuels we have read, And being the young generation, all my audience, you students, you must be a young generation. It is a great request to you that please consume these things very efficiently so that the upcoming generation may not go in the shortage. And we being the citizen, we should be very careful for a good nation. It should not be consumed more. Okay, so this was all for today. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please give a like button. And if you are not subscribed on the channel Ollie Scholar yet, please do subscribe it so that you can get the daily updates of the videos which we are uploading. We upload the video daily. And thank you so much. And you can also go in Google Play. There we have got our app. It's with the name CSCS e-learning. You can just download it. And there you are going to get these videos are there, PDF notes are there. If you are interested for online tests, we conduct online tests also in which MCQ questions are there. And if you are interested in live classes, we conduct that also. There we give one-to-one interaction with children and student, with student and teacher. So you can see in the description box, our mail ID is mentioned. You can mail us if you have got any confusion with any of the topic. We will clarify it to you. So thank you so much. Thank you for watching the video.